Hi there, welcome back. Dan again from CleanGuru. So I think I'm going to make the title of the video Authenticity Without Permission. And see if you agree. I just have noticed this, and I'd love to hear your thoughts on it too. Maybe I'm off base, maybe I'm old-fashioned, or maybe I just don't get it. You be the judge. So it's interesting how we talk about social media, and a lot of times what folks are really looking for, and I get this, is for to get the real, authentic, genuine, real you. Because that's what people can relate to, and that's what they really want to know, the truth. And so that's authenticity, we call that. Well, sometimes, you know, today that can be pushed, right? You hear cursing and vulgarity and disrespect, and you go, boy, is that really authenticity? Sometimes I think we can confuse vulgarity or maybe disrespectfulness with authenticity. I'm not sure that makes you being authentic just because you're being that way. Well, it's interesting how I've seen a variation of it in social media. Have you noticed this? And it affects our industry too in cleaning. I've noticed that people, folks will take pictures or videos of whatever it'll be out in the streets in a different building or even in a house, and they'll take pictures or a video of someone's home. Now in cleaning, it might be a bathroom and someone's trying to point out, you know, how do I clean this grout? Or how do I clean this shower glass? Or this kind of thing. And these are legitimate questions. I have no problem with that. It's just striking, maybe for someone like myself that was raised by people from World War II, that generation, those are my parents. Maybe it just strikes me, I go, to see those images where people, it seems, unless I'm wrong, it seems like maybe they're just taking pictures and videos about some horrific looking family room or bathroom, but I'm not sure they got permission from that family to do that, right? Now they would say, well, you'll never know who that was, and that could be right. But you know, anymore, we're supposed to get people's permission if we want to email to them. I know Tony and I, we always have to not only opt in, we double opt in to try to make sure that we have someone's permission before we email to them. Well, isn't it funny how when you move to someone's, we're out in the streets or in a building or in someone's house, I don't know if folks think about the confusion between authenticity, they're trying to show something real, with actually doing that without permission. I mean, I often think to myself, my goodness, would you want someone in your home taking pictures and showing and posting that on social media without your permission? It might really trouble you. You'd say, my gosh, that's my house. Now, a lot of times, I'm sure there's no way to kind of know that that's that person's home or a bedroom or bathroom or kitchen, but it certainly is striking and interesting, isn't it? The evolution of authenticity, and sometimes without respect, like we talked about, and sometimes maybe even without permission. Something to think about. I think, you know, what do they say? You know, you can't have freedom without responsibility, and I think the freedom of social media is forcing us to maybe face some of these questions of what it means then to be responsible. Till next time, remember that you can do this. You really can.